myself. I'm a man of wealth and taste. I've been around for a long, long
time. Hey guys, so this is today's look. I'm a little bit far. Ooh. Okay. Better. Okay, so this is today's look. It's a kind of smoky green eye. It's really, really fun. It's an awesome going out look. Again, really eye-catching. I know I keep saying that, but still. And it's pretty simple. It's, you don't need to use that many colors, and again, it's just building on top of one another. So I am starting again. My skin's already primed. I already have foundation on, so I'm starting from the eyes.
Prylon eye primer to start out with. Boom. So, first color, Brown Down from MAC. Looks like this, and I am using a 217 MAC brush to add this right into our crease. Just sweeping along our crease and a little bit upward, adding onto that color until I get the amount and darkness of the color I'm looking for. Boom. Next, I'm moving on to my BH palette, and I'm moving on to this mossy green color. Love it. And a Sephora small precise lid brush, and I'm just going to be patting this color right onto my lid and up to the crease, but not into the crease, and just being really delicate with where I put this color, because we don't want this color getting messy. Now, once we have that, I'm moving on to Corduroy from MAC. This is going to be our second crease color. And I'm putting this on with a precise crease brush, sweeping back and forth, following my eye socket pretty much, and just adding the color until I get the darkness that I wanted. Sweeping, boom. Once I have that color, I am taking my Sephora Precise Line brush and sweeping Corduroy right underneath my lash line all the way up to the tear duct and connecting. Now, I'm taking a fluffy blending brush and just blending out any harsh lines that might have occurred from us putting on that crease color. Next, I am taking this beautiful color. It's from Makeup Forever. You can see the shine that comes with it. It's an emerald. And I'm just lightly patting this while building the color right onto that mossy green color that we already put on. These two together make such an amazing highlighted green. Now we're taking that same color and sweeping it right on top of the brown underneath our bottom lashes. Just building up until I have the color that I desire. There you go. Now I'm lining my whole lid with my L'Oreal Black Liquid Eyeliner. And I'm also going to be creating a little bit of a cat eye that just follows the outer V of my eye shape. You know, just making that line nice and precise. And now I'm taking NARS Albatross and a Real Techniques crease brush and just highlighting right on my brow bone and underneath the eyebrow, give a nice highlight to our eye. And after that, I'm going to be taking my Monda lashes and my L'Oreal Telescopic and adding these two to my eyes. And after that, I'm taking my L'Oreal Infallible Black Eyeliner. This is one of my favorite eyeliners for watering the waterline and also tight lining our upper lashes. So we're just gonna be doing that. And for the lashes, I didn't pick extremely long lashes or anything like that. I picked really together voluminous lashes. We just want a lot of volume for this look, not really length. So just keep adding that black eyeliner until you have the darkness that you want, the intensity that you like. Don't be afraid, pack that on. So after that, we gotta do some cleanup underneath and down the center to brighten our face. So I'm taking my concealer, this is MAC Prep and Prime, and with the help of my Beauty Blender, just blending the concealer along underneath my eyes, really, really helping with any fallout that might have occurred with the eyeshadows, and just helping make the eyes look more precise, more clean. And of course, adding concealer down the center of the face, so on the chin, underneath the nose, and down the center of the nose and forehead. Eyebrows, Anastasia, brow powder, and pencil. Now, for my Hourglass lighting powders, I'm taking this nice one and my Real Techniques powder brush, and I'm just patting this on. I don't really like sweeping it because I don't want to maybe move the concealer in any way. Just patting this color lightly onto the concealer and brightening up anywhere that I had put that MAC Prep and Prime. Now moving on to Hoola Bronzer from Benefit. Starting out with putting it under my cheekbones. Also putting it on the temples and blending it into the forehead. Making sure everything is nice and blended away. We're also going to be adding bronzer underneath our jawline and chin and down the bridge of our nose and blending that out with the Beauty Blender. Yay! Blush. I'm using Fleur from MAC and I'm just applying this blush heavily on the outsides of my face and blending in towards my apples, creating a very nice soft pink color. Very cute. Look at that. Yay! Boom, back to the lighting powders. I'm taking this darker one and just patting it on next to the bridge, adding a little bit of a luminescent warmth to my skin. I really want my skin to glow. Now I'm taking my Bare Minerals highlighter and a pencil brush, just dotting this right next to the tear ducts of my eyes. This is gonna help brighten them up, make them look a little bit more awake. Boom, there you go. Now you know what time it is, lips. Starting out with Spice from MAC, one of my absolute favorite natural lip liners. And I'm going to be lining my lips with this and also filling them in with the color, like I always do. And so once we have our lips nicely lined, I'm moving on to Speak Your Mind from Bare Minerals, a very nice pink. But I don't want my lips to be too pink for this look, so now I'm going to be moving on to Be Free from Bare Minerals, one of my favorite nude lipsticks, just softening that pink out a bit. But I did forget something. If I want my skin to look highlighted and dewy, gotta use a Chaos Makeup Highlighter. This one is in Vienne Rose. I'm just applying this right on top of my cheekbones and blending upwards and out. And also, of course, I'm applying this down the center of my face to give my face a really nice highlighted, dewy glow. And you know what? To top it off, I'm taking a little bit of that highlighter and just patting it on the center of my lips, giving my lips a little bit of a glow from the center, which makes them look a little bit bigger. Little bit bigger, yeah. Just patting it on.
Okay, guys, so this is the final look. It's just a kind of emerald, smoky, green eye-esque look. I don't know. But emeralds and greens are huge this fall and winter, so I thought why not incorporate it into like a going out makeup look? Why not? So thank you for tuning in. Please go to my blog to see a list of all the products. And now I'm also showing what brushes I used with everything. So products and brushes. And I'm gonna do some more swatches and makeup reviews soon. So that should be fun. So thank you for tuning in and I will see you guys next time. Peace and love.